Okay, so I want to give you a few tools to solve exponential and log equations. And so the main tools that we use in these equations is one of the properties of the function themselves. So I'll maybe remind you really quickly about just kind of what exponential functions look like. The basic shape, if I don't move it around for an exponential function, either looks like this or like this. You guys kind of remember that, okay? So this one on the left is exponential growth. Exponential decay is here on the right. And one of the amazing things about these functions is, like for the growth function, it's always getting higher and higher and higher, or always increasing. So we say it's increasing on really minus infinity to infinity, right? If you move from left to right, you're always going up the hill. Decay is always decreasing. If I move from left to right, I'm always walking down a hill, right? Okay. So this particular thing, when it's strictly increasing like this, also means a case where it's called a one-to-one function. Now, this one-to-one function means informally, each output, either f of x or y value, is associated with only one x value, or maybe at most one. Some of them are not associated with any x values, but they're only associated with one x value, meaning only one input value. So I can easily go from the output value back to the input value. Do you guys remember the definition of a function where if I have an input, it goes to exactly one output, right? It's this idea of predictability of the function. This goes in the reverse direction. Every output is also only going back to one input. Okay, so this gives me a really nice, really, really nice way of solving kind of exponential and log equations. And so I want to talk about a couple ways to solve. One is by using this one-to-one property. Okay. And the one-to-one property for exponential functions looks something like this. So if I have a base raised to some power u, and it's equal to the same base raised to that power v, then that implies then u equals v. Also, if u equals v, then I can go the reverse direction, b to the u equals b to the v. So I can go in either one of these directions that helps me. So you should think of these as tools that you're using in the right place, okay? This is also true for log equations. So two, if let's say log base b of u is equal to log base b of v, then I can go back to the inputs, right? So like this first equation, I want to kind of make sure we're understanding. This equation is an equaling of the outputs. And if I know the output values are equal for this log function, then the inputs have to be equal. That's what the one-to-one property tells me, okay? So, but then if u equals v, then also log base b of u equals log base b of v. And we use this direction. This is typically described as taking the log of both sides. Okay, so we'll see that in example. So I want to do that. The other way that we solve, there's a third way that we kind of solve these log and exponential equations. And the third way is that we convert to the associated log or exponential equation. That is, convert between forms. So if I have an exponential equation, I can convert to a log equation and see if that helps me out. If I have a log equation, I can convert back to the exponential form of that equation and see if that helps me solve. Okay? So I want to use these three properties, but you should keep these things in mind. I'm using one of these three things every time I'm going to solve these equations. Okay, so I'm going to do some examples. Okay, so for example, let's say I have this exponential equation, like 2 squared is equal to 2 to the x plus 2, right? So I have the bases the same. And then, so I'm using this property. If I know b to some power is equal to b to some other power, then I know that the exponents are equal. Okay, I feel like these one-to-one properties are very intuitive, right? If 2 squared is equal to 2 to some other power, then what you really do to solve this is you immediately go to this exponent equation here. 2 is equal to x plus 2. Right? This one, that input goes right, and that goes there. Okay? And then you just solve. So I subtract 2 from both sides, so I get 0 is equal to x. And that's your solution. You should plug your solution back in and check. Okay. Okay, so that's one example. Let's say another example, a second example. Oops, I'm sorry. So, okay, I'm gonna start on this new page because it's super scrolling. So another example of where you might see an exponential equation looks more like this. 10 to the x is equal to 2. Now see, this doesn't fit the mold of b to the u is equal to b to the v, right? I have 10 over here as the base, and over here it's 2. And there's no way that I can make it look like this. I can't make it look be 10 to the x equal 10 to something else very easily. So it's possible that I could use instead of this, so like I think, oh, okay, that is not going to work. Maybe I'll convert. So I can convert this to a log equation, right? So I remember this and I forget which form I gave it in. So let's say that it was b to the x is equal to y. And then that is equivalent to log base b of y is equal to x. That I have these three placeholders. And I sometimes use a, b, and c's and different things in here, but one of these versions, right? So I have an equation in this left form, and I want to see and convert it to this right form and see if that helps me. Okay? So I'm going to convert this here. This is log base 10 of 2 is equal to x, and we really know log base 10 is log 2 is equal to x. And so even though I don't know off the top of my head what log 2 is, that's a really easy thing to find with my calculator. And when I put log 2 in, I get x is equal to 0.301. Okay, so I get an act like an answer. Log 2 is something that I can find. Okay, another way to do this problem, and I maybe want to make a differentiation here. This problem on the top of the screen was really nice because I was in base 10, and that's one of the logs that I have on my calculator. This problem changes if I have this, 7 to the x is equal to 2. You can still convert this, if you want to be log base 7 of 2 is equal to x, but then computing this gets more complicated. You have to know a change of base formula, and maybe you don't know that. But the other thing that you can do is you can use this one-to-one property for logs. Okay, so like this is complicated. You can do it this way. I think usually what people do instead is use this thing that if u is equal to v, then they know that I can take log of u is equal to log v. And they can use log base 10, but this is also true if you want to use natural log, whichever one. So, and this is the one that they think of as taking the log of both sides. So if I come here, and I'm going to come and bring this problem, right? And I have 7 to the x is equal to 2. And really this is, now I want to think of this as taking the log of both sides. Natural log x is equal to natural log 2. I use the power rule to bring this x out front and simplify. Because my main goal is to get this x out of the exponent place. Okay, so I bring it out front. Now this is x times natural log of x. In order to get rid of this natural log of x, natural log of 7. X times natural log of 7 on the left is equal to natural log of 2. In order to get rid of this, this is one quantity here that's a number. You just divide by it. You divide both sides by natural log 7. And you get x is equal to natural log 2 over natural log 7. And again, this is something that you can plug into your calculator. Natural log 2, close that parenthesis, divided by natural log 7, close that parenthesis. And I get x is equal to 0.3562. Again, I'm going to check this. In my original equation. The check is good for you. It helps you figure out if you missed anything or like made a mistake along the way. It's really not that hard to check, so I'm checking it right now. So 7 to this power, and I get somewhere around 2. Okay, if you round this, when you raise 7 to this 0.3562, you get, like, it's around 2, but on my calculator I get 1.999997. So you don't get something exact, you get something about 2, but you understand that's because you cut off a lot of this number here. So it won't be exactly 2. Okay? I want to do another couple. Okay, so now I want to think about some log equations. I just want to give you kind of a brief start, because I think as you practice, this gets a little bit easier. So for example, here's a kind of simple log equation. Log 3x is equal to 2. And in the same way, when I have an exponential equation and I have an x in the exponent, logs help me bring that outside. In the same way, it's hard to get this x outside of the log without converting, right? So one of the choices is if I have, so this one-to-one property says if I have log base b of something, then this is equal to log base b, and if I have an equality like this, then I can get u equals v. But I only have one log on the left side. Right? I don't have another log on the other side, so this doesn't really help me if I'm thinking about this. So I'm going to throw out that idea. I can use maybe try to convert. Okay? So when I try to convert, I'll turn this equation into 3 is the base still, 2 is the exponent, and that's equal to x. And immediately I get x is equal to 9. Just by converting, you turn this into an equation that you can solve really easily. Okay? Again, check that log base 3 of 9 is actually equal to 2. Pull this one out of your book. So, log base b of x plus 2 plus log base b of x is equal to log b of 24. Now, this kind of does look, now I'm going to revisit. You see this thing that I did before, right? I'm going to revisit that and think, well, now I have several logs floating around. Not just one, though, but I can use those log properties that I learned to kind of combine them. So I'm going to combine this stuff on the left using the multiplication property to get log base b of x plus 2 times x is equal to log base b of 24. And now I have a log equal a log. And so now I can use this property and make the inside pieces, that piece and that piece, just equal. So now inside here I'm going to multiply these. That's x squared plus 2x equal to 24. Okay. And to solve this, I need to use, this is a quadratic equation because there's an x squared in there. So minus 24 equals 0. I'll factor x, let's see, plus 6 and minus 4, is that right? Equals 0. So I get x is equal to negative 6 and x is equal to 4. So even if you, and so I'm going to check this real quick, I'll show you. So when I check, I want to remind you of what the graph of natural log looks like. It looks something like this, or any log, but it isn't defined for these values 0 and to the left of 0. So the domain of this function is 0 to infinity. Domain of logs. That means what I'm allowed to plug in. So most of the check here is to make sure that when I plug in, say, negative 6, I'm not getting a negative number in here. So, like when I plug it in, log base b of negative 6 plus 2 is going to give me, and then I can put it into the rest, but this is my problem that I recognize it immediately. So, right here, I'll have log base b of negative 4. This is a problem. Because log of any, like once you simplify this, log of any negative value isn't defined. Okay, you have to plug it in to see. If you plug in 4 into this thing, so log base b of 4 plus 2 plus log base b of 4 equals log b of 24, you'll see all of these are positive. That's fine. That will be a solution. But the only solution here is x is equal to 4, not this x is equal to 6, because x equal to 6 is outside the domain of these functions that are involved. Okay? Okay, so think about, let me just make sure. Yeah, think about how you're solving this. I think there's one more video using E, the natural base, and natural log, and a few more of those examples. But hopefully, this should give you a good start on exponential and log equations.